In this episode of Star Hopping with Kissimmee Park Observatory, we'll look at the Gemini region and show you how to find these beautiful deep sky objects. The Rosette Nebula. The Christmas Tree Cluster. And the Open Cluster, M35. All right, let's go star hopping. Hey, hello, hi, and welcome to episode 9 of Star Hopping with Kissimmee Park Observatory. I'm Dave Hearn, and I'm absolutely elated to be your host. In this series of programs, we'll show you the most beautiful sights in the night sky and explain exactly how to find them with your binoculars or your telescope. So we're not on our spaceship set this week, as we're coming to you from Key West, Florida, while our family prepares for the Thanksgiving holiday. I hope you like the tropical holiday background here. I wanted to make sure we didn't miss a single week of star hopping. Well, now we're back to our standard content after those 2 weeks of star hopping extras, where we discussed how to pick out telescopes for beginners. As we're approaching the holiday season, I know that many parents will be looking to select a telescope. So if you're in the market for a new scope, check out those two videos. You can just click on the thumbnail below to check it out. So during our extra episodes, the stars have had some time to rise a bit, and Orion is now halfway up in the sky at about 10:30 p.m. We looked at Orion a few weeks ago, but there's a lot of other great areas close by that need our attention. The constellation of Gemini, with the bright stars Castor and Pollux, and the dimmer but very rich constellation of Monoceros, both have a bunch of great deep sky objects within their borders. Some people just starting out in observing may not be aware of Monoceros. It lies between Orion and Gemini, and the winter Milky Way runs right through the middle of it. Our first target for this episode is smack in the middle of Monoceros, the gorgeous Rosette Nebula. This is a large area of nebulosity in an area of active starbirth that lies about 5,200 light years away. There's a bright open star cluster in the center, NGC 2244, which is easily seen in binoculars, and this will be the target of our star hop. To locate the Rosette Nebula, we'll be starting on the bright star Betelgeuse in the constellation of Orion. About 8 degrees down from Betelgeuse is the fourth magnitude star Epsilon Monoceratus. This is a pretty big move into an area without any bright stars, so make sure you have the right star before you do your move. Once you're on Epsilon, you're pretty close to our target. About 2 degrees to the lower left, you'll see a group of about 6 stars in a rectangular shape. This is NGC 2244, the open cluster at the heart of the Rosette Nebula. With a wide field eyepiece, you might be able to see some of the brighter structures of the Rosette. It's very large, measuring 60 by 80 minutes of arc. For comparison, the full moon is 30 arc minutes across, so the Rosette is over twice the size of the full moon. Ready to move on to our second target? Appropriate for the approaching holiday season, we're going to locate the Christmas Tree Cluster. This area of star clusters and nebulosity is beautiful in astrophotos, like this one from KPO. To locate this photogenic grouping, we'll be starting at the bright star Pollux in the constellation of Gemini. This first magnitude star is easy to see with its companion Castor. Pollux is the brighter and lower of these two beacons. From Pollux, move about 8 degrees to the upper right to find the star Wasat. What's that? Wasat. Shining at magnitude 3.5. The next hop is the upper right, about 3 degrees, to the fourth magnitude star, Mechbuda. The next hop is a long one, but fairly easy. Move about 8 degrees to the upper right to the bright second magnitude star Alhena. Now we'll make a hard right turn and move about 3 degrees down to the third magnitude star Alzir, passing its neighborhood companion 30 Geminorian. Now we move to the base of the Christmas tree by slewing 3 degrees to the right across the border into Monoceros to the fifth magnitude star S Monoceratus. In binoculars, you can see a triangular pattern of stars resembling the shape of a pine tree with S Monoceratus at its base. This is the Christmas Tree Cluster, also known as NGC 2264. It's a very complex area of young stars and nebulosity. In astrophotos, the famous Cone Nebula can be seen. This feature is extremely difficult to see visually, even with filters. This region lies about 2,600 light years away and is a very active star-forming region. Ready for our last target? Good, because it's M35, which is one of the most famous of open clusters. With only your unaided eye, you can find this cluster near the 3 foot stars of Gemini under fairly good observing conditions. M35 is a splendid sight in a small telescope, best seen in a low power eyepiece. The cluster contains over 120 stars from 6th to 13th magnitude within a half degree area, about the size of the full moon, and it contains more than 500 stars in total. To find M35, we'll start from the bright star Alhena that we just passed on our way to the Christmas tree cluster. From Alhena, move about 4 degrees to the upper left to the 4th magnitude star New Geminorium. Now move in the same direction about 3 degrees to the 3rd magnitude star Tejat Posterior. Next, move about 2 degrees up and slightly right to the 3rd magnitude star Propus. During this last move, you'll pass right through IC 443, also known as the Jellyfish Nebula, but it's so faint you won't notice it. This is one target I have my eye on to image at KPO for a while, maybe this winter sometime. The next couple of stars in this hop are fainter. Move about a degree straight up to 3 Geminorium. You'll pass 7th magnitude star 4 Geminorium on the way there. We're getting close now, so hang in there. Move about 2 degrees to the left to 6th magnitude 5 Geminorium. Now move about a half degree upwards and you'll run into a mass of stars that form the open cluster Messier 35. In a wide field scope, you'll see the 100 or so stars that form M35. And then to the upper right, about a half degree, you'll see a small tight open cluster, NGC 2158. These two make an attractive pair in astrophotos. So that's our three objects for this episode. We started off with locating the large and gorgeous Rosette Nebula in the Noceros. Then we moved a little up and to the left and used our star hopping to focus on the Christmas tree cluster and the adjacent Cone Nebula. We finished up by traversing the stars of Gemini and located the pretty open star cluster Messier 35. There are tons more great deep sky objects in this area that we can look at in the coming weeks. With all that said, we'd like to wish you and yours a happy and star-filled Thanksgiving. Step out and look at the stars tonight after your carbohydrate rush wears off. I hope you've enjoyed star hopping around the Milky Way. We'll continue to bring you these astronomy tutorials every week on Thursdays. They'll be designed to help you find deep sky objects that are up in the sky at the time we post them to YouTube. Our main reason for creating these videos is to help beginning amateur astronomers learn the sky and get more enjoyment out of their telescopes and astronomy in general. If you have any requests or suggestions of potential targets in the night sky that you'd like to see us present here, just let us know down in the comments section below. If you found this video useful, please consider subscribing to our channel down there, click on the thumbs up, and please share it out to your friends who like looking at stars. Also, as I just mentioned, please feel free to leave any question or comment below, and we'll be sure to respond quickly. Also, please follow KPO on Facebook, where we post all of our astrophotos and keep everyone informed about upcoming astronomical events. We'd love to hear from you to discuss all this great stuff up in the sky. All the links to these places, including our website, kpobservatory.org, can be found below in the episode notes as well. And finally, if you feel this video provides you value and you'd like to see more, please consider supporting us on Patreon, where for a couple dollars per video, you can support our efforts and let us make even more great astronomy tutorials just like this one. Well, thanks again for watching, and we'll see you next time on Star Hopping with Kissimmee Park Observatory.